Another good news, this is the bicameral report of the Foreign Investments Act. So, Mr. President, we're in receipt of the bicameral conference committee report on the disagreeing provisions of Senate Bill number 115 and House Bill number 300. With the permission of the body, may we recognize the chairperson of the Senate panel, our distinguished colleague from the Ilocandia, the nation of the north, to give us the highlights of the bicameral conference committee report.
The pride of Ilocandia, Apo Senator Imee Marcos is recognized chairperson.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, finally, yes.
Yes, finally, I'm sorry. Yes, I seem to be getting muted. In any case, thank you, Mr. President and Majority Leader. And I have the honor to submit for ratification the bicameral conference committee report for the disagreeing provisions, Senate Bill 1156 and House Bill 300, also known as the Amendment to the Foreign Investments Act of 1991. From a single line, single provision bill, simply lowering the investment minimum, I think we have finally a far more comprehensive and pragmatic law. And among the agreements settled by both panels are many improvements provided by the House. The bicameral conference agreed to use the Senate version as the working draft. First, Section 2 was adopted, clarifying the definition of investment and the practice of professions, in particular, adopting the Professional Regulatory Commission definition of professions as an activity or undertaking rendered and performed by a registered and duly licensed professional or holder of a special temporary permit as defined by the scope of practice of a professional regulatory law. Senator Joel Villanueva is highly familiar with this rather contentious definition, given the number of foreign workers that have come to work in our country. Section 3 was also adopted, with the House panel proposing changes in the composition of the Interagency Investment Promotion Coordination Committee. It's a mouthful, but I believe the change designating the DOF secretary as the vice chairman and the addition of another representative from NCR in addition to Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao will actually promote and render inclusive the agency concerned. Section 6 was adopted with the House panel agreeing to the establishment of an online portal for foreign investors as urged by Senator Sherwin Gatchalian. Section 7 was adopted with the House panel providing for clarifying language in compliance with the export requirements under CREATE or Title 13 of the National Internal Revenue Code as highlighted by Senator Pia Cayetano. Section 8 was adopted, rationalizing language on the labor requirements for the employment of lower paid up capital of US$100,000. The reconciled version also strengthens the language for the recognition of the rights of employees and institutionalizes the requirement of understudy programs for alien employment permit as invoked by Senator Joel Villanueva. Section 9 regarding the National Security Review was adopted with the House panel providing clarification on the industries to be reviewed. They are now limited, similar to the insights provided by our own Senator Drilon and Senator Ontiveros. They are now limited to foreign investments involving military-related industries, cyber infrastructure, pipeline transportation, or such other activities which may threaten territorial integrity and the safety, security, and well-being of Filipino citizens. Section 10, or the anti-gaffe provision of the House, was adopted, simplifying our list of penalties. This will now read that any public official or employee involved in foreign investment promotions who shall commit any of the acts under Section 3 of Republic Act 1319, otherwise known as the Anti-Graft and Corruptions Practices Act, shall, in addition to the penalties provided under Section 9A of said Act, be punished by a fine, not less than 2 million pesos, not more than 5 million pesos. Section 13 was further adopted from the Senate version, with the House panel increasing the appropriation of 50 million pesos to be sourced from the contingent fund from the initial allocation, the initial Ilocano allocation of 10 million, which they claimed was unworkable and for which I was grateful. Mr. President, I am grateful to the House panel for their generosity and openness in accepting our thoroughgoing changes and their significant introduction of many amendments improving the law that we see now. As well as, I must send our gratitude to the many foreign chambers, the Ecozones, as well as PESA, BOI of DTI, the BPO and other groups, the business sectors that were untiring and generous in their efforts to put together a new law that would truly liberalize the Philippines in the age of this pandemic. I also enjoin my colleagues to support the further effort to open up our economy and invite foreign investors in these difficult times. Thank you very much.